In this screencast, we will discuss the method of tuning that is done by using controller synthesis. Controller synthesis represents a different approach to tuning than the more common methods such as Ziegler-Nichols, Cohen-Kuhn, Tiberius-Lieben, etc. So in these models, what you do is you pick a process model and you pick a particular PID controller, P only, PI, PD, etc., and you end up with a particular response. So therefore, the parameters of Ziegler-Nichols, for example, are selected such that the system has a quarter decay response. There are other tuning models, some done by Smith and Carripio, where you are trying to minimize an integral error. So really, what they're doing for those is you're picking a model, and you're particularly a member of the PID family to get some sort of desired response, quarter decay, reduced integral error, etc. Controller synthesis, the approach is a little different. So in controller synthesis, you still do pick a process model, but the thing which you now also do is you pick a response, and then what happens is what you get at the end is a particular controller type. So a point here of note is the fact that the process models here are not exactly treated the same, because with the other models, Ziegler-Nichols et al., those can be found by using data without knowing exactly what the transfer function models are. Whereas in controller synthesis, a process model explicitly does need to be known. So we can view this by looking at a block diagram. But in this case, when controller synthesis is analyzed, it is a simplified block diagram, where we have some sort of input variable x, a transfer function for the controller GC, and a transfer function G, where this transfer function includes everything that's not the controller. So this would include the sensor transmitter, the valve, and the process. And then you have your output variable y. So if we do some block diagram algebra here, we can follow the fact from this branching point that this is y. So what we're left with at the summing point is x minus y, and this will leave us with x minus y multiplied by gc times g, and that means we've gone through these two blocks. That means that we're left here, which means that this is also equal to y. But the important part to remember here is what we're now trying to do is synthesize a controller. So usually when we do this block diagram analysis, what we're usually trying to do is determine their response, y over x. But what we're now interested in doing here is isolating the controller and finding that transfer function. So therefore here we'll have that GC will equal y over g multiplied by x minus y, which we're going to rewrite very slightly as 1 over g multiplied by y over x minus y. What we're now going to do is multiply this second term by 1 over x over 1 over x. And when we do that, we develop a controller transfer function of gc equals 1 over g multiplied by y over x divided by 1 minus y over x. So as I've just noted, this y minus x term represents a response of the output to a change in the input. So if we specify a transfer function that represents the sensor transmitter valve and process, and we specify a desired response, we can tease out what the controller transfer function should be. And not only that, we can also find what the value of the relevant parameters are, kc, tau i, tau d. So the question that we have to ask ourselves is what do we choose for y over x? And the answer to this is what we really desire here is a relatively simple type of response. And generally, the most simple type of response we have is the well-behaved first-order transfer function, where y over x equals 1 over tau c s plus 1. So this is the transfer function that is ideally chosen because it's a smooth function, and it's one that can easily be used from an analytical standpoint. But what you might be asking yourself is, why not perfect control? So if we think about what perfect control would represent a transfer function of, if I make a change in x, I would expect Y to change immediately and to reach that value, particularly when we're talking about Y and X, where X is typically Y set point. So perfect control here, we would want an instantaneous change in the output as an effect of the input. In other words, that means no dead time, no time dynamics. So what we would want is 1. But what we note here is if we substitute that into the equation for the controller transfer function, what that leads to is GC equals 1 over G multiplied by 1 over 1 minus 1. And that causes a problem because that would mean the fact that GC would equal infinity. This can't happen. So therefore, this further proves the concept of the fact that feedback control cannot be perfect control, cannot be instantaneous control, which physically makes sense because a feedback controller does not work until the final value, the controlled variable, actually sees a change to it. Besides that, it will not act. So thus, it makes sense for a feedback-only system to not have perfect control. To show an example of how controller synthesis works, we'll just take a look at a simple first-order process where G equals some gain over tau S plus 1. So when we substitute in here, we'll have GC equals 1 over K over tau S plus 1. That's our value for G. And then we'll have our second term, which is, to show it here, Y over X divided by 1 minus Y over X. So remember that we're assuming that Y over X is 1 over tau C S plus 1. So what we'll now do is find a least common denominator for this denominator right here. So this will now become tau s plus 1 over k multiplied by 1 over tau cs plus 1 divided by tau cs plus 1 minus 1 over tau cs plus 1. We have a few cancellations here. We have the tau cs plus 1s in both parentheses that go away, and we have the 1 minus 1 that goes away. So what this leaves us with our controller transfer function is GC equals tau S plus 1 over K multiplied by 1 over tau CS. So the functions that we have here is in fact a PID family controller, but it just doesn't look right. So therefore what we have to do is we have to rearrange the equation a little bit to get it into the PID controller form. Remember that the PID equation is KC times 1 plus 1 over tau IS, the I control part, plus tau DS, the D control part. So if we look at our terms here for a second, we see that we have a tau S plus 1 in the numerator, so we have an order of S and an order of the constant, or 0, in the numerator, and we have an order of S in the denominator. So therefore, if we divide those terms, we'll have S over S, which will be a constant, and we'll have 1 over S, which will be a 1 over S term. So that tells us the fact that we're going to have something with the 1 and something with the 1 over tau IS. So therefore, we know we're going to be heading towards a PI controller. But to do this rearrangement, what we'll do is we'll do a little bit of math here. We'll do the fact that GC equals, we'll actually split the terms, and we'll have tau S over K tau CS plus 1 over K times tau CS. And in order to get this form, we need to have the constant 1, so therefore the S's here cancel. So this is the constant term, so therefore that is going to be what's pulled out of the equation. So therefore we'll have tau over k tau c times 1 plus 1 over tau s, because the k tau c will already factor out, and in order to have that tau in the numerator, we have to counteract it with the tau in the denominator for this term. So if we look at this, what we see is the tau over k tau c term is our definition of kc, and tau I will just simply be the time constant of the g, of that combined process, sensor, transmitter, and valve. So therefore here, instead of using Ziegler-Nichols method where we say we want a PID controller, this method gives us the controller out. So an important point to note here is the fact that sometimes the controllers that are synthesized can be physically unrealizable or impractical. And secondly, we've talked K, tau, are the two constants from the G, those we found by understanding the process, but tau C is a value that is often dependent on that G transfer function, the sensor, transmitter, valve, process combination. There are various correlations that exist, and they are available in various textbooks and in the literature. So in this screencast, we took a look at another way to develop optimal tuning parameters by developing the controller transfer function and finding the controller parameters from that information.